In this video, we are going to learn how to create a beautiful slider like this with fancy effect by using Sketch and Flinto. What's up everyone, my name is Faiz and welcome back to another episode. And today we are going to learn how to create a beautiful slider by using Sketch and Flinto. And I'm going to teach you everything about this slider, how I made by using very simple trick in Flinto. So guys, first of all, I'm going to give you some basic knowledge about this, that how I have created this slider into Sketch. So what I did, I just simply created this header and the text, and this is my button. This button is going to slide next and slide back, and this one is my upcoming slide preview with image, and this one is text what is upcoming. So if I click on this, I will redirect on this one, and you can see this is also same, just I changed the color and the change the previous image. Like if I'm here, so this is my next upcoming post or slider which is about to come, and same is this one. So how I have designed this thing into Sketch, so what I did, I used the grid system over here to design this kind of slider. It was so much tough when I started to build that kind of grid system. So now you can see this is my grid system. On this behalf, I created that kind of slider. So right now you can see this is my 5-column grid system. It is a 5-column, half this and half this complete one, and this one is 5 column and 5 rows grid system. So I just simply build this, and after that I just created all things, like you can see this one and this one, and I also divide into the two columns and two rows, which helped me a lot. This is my section for the arrows button. So it was, and don't worry guys, if you don't know how to create this and if you are worrying about this, how I can build the system, I'm gonna give you this file link in description. You can download from my Dropbox. So after this, what I did, so you can see I built this, I created this design behalf on this grid. So now you can see everything is so much controlled with my grid system. Even my text, you can see, even my button, even my navigation bar, even this preview and the site padding or the margin, whatever. So I hope you understand how I created this. Now I'm going to move into Flinto and teach you how I created the beautiful transition into Flinto. So I don't know why I'm looking at this option last few days, like Flinto is not more supported with Sketch. I don't understand this meaning, but when I went the Flinto website for Sketch plugin, it is still available for the older version. I don't know why, but it's working good, it's working fine, you can still work with that. So right now we are into Flinto. It's awesome, the beautiful interface we have. So now the one thing I'm gonna tell you right now, whatever I have done with the help of behavior, just simply behavior done everything for me. It is a really great nice job behavior done for me. So now what I'm going to do, just simply copy this image and select this image by pressing the command button in your keyboard and paste over here. And what you have to do, just simply keep this image below this, your main image. And the same is, you have to do this, you have to copy this one and you have to keep this image. Just select your image, you can see it's selected, and paste over here and keep like this. And now just copy this text, select this text and paste over here, and just keep like this. like this. It's amazing. And also going to copy this background and just select this background, this one, and paste over here. And you can resize this, you can also drag bottom, whatever you want, you can do. Just simple. And now also this one, just copy this section, or just copy this background first and select this background, this one, by pressing command key in your keyboard, and just resize this like whatever you want. You can do, you can adjust size, or you can do resize according your need. And now just select this content, and what I'm going to do, just so this is a little mistake what I did, I'm going to copy only this content, this one and this one, just text layer, right? So it's very important, you have to organize everything into layer while you're doing animation into Flinto. This help you a lot. And paste over here so you can see the first one and the last one. So now I'm gonna keep this layer over here like this. So finally we have all things, and we don't left anything. Yes, amazing. So what I'm going to do over here, just reset the opacity, just keep the zero opacity like this one and this one, and this section, this one. So what it will have, what will happen, it will give you the smooth look of your slider, like the transition effect, like with the fade up and the fade in, it will help you to give this kind of look. If you will keep the opacity zero over here, you can do after animation too. It's depend on you. So now we have clean slider. So right now what we are going to do, just simply select everything beside my navigation bar and this arrow, just going to put over here. I don't need this arrow at all, and just going to select my whole content. So now you can see it is whole selection, and just going to click on the behavior, the beautiful feature of Flinto. Just click on this behavior. Now we are into behavior. So first thing, we are going to play with big section, the big image. Just click on the add button to add new stage like this. I have a different stage, and in this stage I am going to place this thing, this image like this. It is not visible right now. Now if you click on this opacity, now you will see it is there. Amazing. And this section, this one is previous section, I'm gonna put below this, and going to add opacity to give the beautiful transition effect. So like this. Now if I see this one, so now you can see it's fading. Now you will see this perfectly. Now you can see it's beautiful, it's so much beautiful. And I have some animations property which I have written in my copy, which I'm going to put over here. If you will put the same value, it will give you the beautiful effect, and according to you, you can make your own effect. So like let's suppose this one, I'm using UI kid. Okay, so in UI kid I'm using dumping like 0.7, just like some bouncy effect. You can see it's bouncy, and the opacity it's 0.1, and just duration what I'm using, it's 1 second, to give the smooth animation. And I have a delay time also, which is 250 ms. So what will happen, let me tell you, it will apply, it applied on this. So now you can see it's beautiful. I have to apply also on this, so it's so much beautiful. So like this. And if I come on this, I have to apply over there. Just once again click on the UI kit, and like 0.7 and like -1, and this one is 1 second, and this one is 250 ms. So now it's fixed. Whenever you are going to use the animation over here, it will automatically apply the same animation on every element until you touch this property. So like you can see, it's beautiful, it's so much smooth, right? Same as I'm gonna put this property on every element like this one. So first of all, just if I click on the new stage, so I have to change this stage, like just dragging down and like just putting this section up. So now my layers is nicely sliced, so it is so much helpful for me to make changes very quickly. So you can see, wow, this one is beautiful. So it is so much nice. I'm so happy that it's working fine. So now the same thing is going to happen with this. So I have the second content. If I come on this, I have two taxes, right? So first text, this one, let me just, I'm gonna manage this just simply like this, and going to put this one inside this. So, and the opacity will be 0. So now you will see, wow, it's beautiful. The same animation is calling again and again and again. This one, this rectangle, if I say I need to resize this and give some opacity and like this, and this one will be gone like this. So let's see what will happen. So if I say, wow, this is beautiful, this is it's giving me like bouncing effect. I'm enjoying this effect a lot. So okay, that's amazing. And this one is same. What I'm going to do, just select this one and this one my content, and let me add 100% opacity and just dragging up, setting things like this, and just my content putting down like this. I'm doing everything so much equally. Where I have put it the content, I'm putting the same content again over there. So I'm using the principle discipline of design. So you can see everything is so much cool. So it's beautiful. So right now, just I forgot one thing more. Just single behavior, click on the edit behavior if you want to edit. So just what you have to do, it will not work on preview button. Why? You have to connect this initialize stage with new stage. So what you have to do, just press the right click and drag into the new state. It will ask you the timeout and you have to give 2 seconds, or you can give whatever you want, but for me it's 2 seconds quite enough. And again the backlink we have to give like 2 seconds. This is fine. And so now when you click on the play button, and you have something beautiful like this, beautiful. So now you can see, this is amazing. And I think this is this is looking beautiful. And the one more thing, if you require that you don't want to use the autoplay option and you want to interact by using this button or this button, so what you have to do, just simply go to in your behavior once again and remove this timing like this. And this one also, remove this, select your initialize screen and select this one button and give the tap just over here and select new stage. And now when you will click on this, it will redirect on this. Let me check it's working or not. So if I click on this, fine. So now what you have to do, again you have to place this link into this by using right click and play button with this. And now we have to look at this. Amazing, it's not working. So what you have to do, again you have to make another gesture, just remove this one and make another gesture. it will go backlink. I think backlink will help it. Let me check it's working or not. Yes. So now you can see it's so much beautiful. What happened? It's not working. Let me check. Give me a second. So we have a two colors, right? Oh, oops. We forgot to add the colors over here. So let me add this color and this one going to down and the opacity. And now let's check. Sorry guys, I really forget to add the color in background. So wow, this is looking beautiful. I hope you like this video, and if you like this video, just hit the like button and give me a lots of love. And if you are new watching to me, just hit the subscribe button and subscribe my channel. And guys, we are going to cross almost 900 and expecting 1000 subscribers in this month. Please hit the subscribe button and subscribe my channel. And I'm coming with new video just very soon. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thanks a lot.